Hi, this is Amy from the Altis store. Now we've been doing a series of videos where we're demonstrating how the best way is to wire up mismatched solar panels. So we've already done, you've got the same voltage, but different amps and watts. We've done the same watts, different amps and volts. Now we're going to do the same amps, different volts and watts. Now, definitely with all these tests we're doing, absolutely the best way to do this is to have each solar panel have its own independent charge controller if you've got very different solar panels. But if that's not an option, we're just giving you some ideas of how you can maximize it and make the best out of the not the perfect situation. So we have two solar panels, 100 watt 24 volt solar panel with a short circuit current of 3.03 amps and an open circuit voltage of about 44 volts. And I've got a 50 watt solar panel with the ISC, the short circuit current, also at 3.03 amps, and its VOC is half of that. It's about 22 volts. So we're going to show you the power that they output going through an MPPT charge controller into my 12 volt battery. And then we will be able to see independently how much power they put out and also how much power if we wire them in series and parallel. All right, so let's get started. Right now, I've got the 24 volt, 100 watt solar panel connected through my MPPT charge controller to the battery, and I'm reading 34.7 volts in. That makes sense. It's got a VMP of 36 volts, and it's kind of hot out, so the voltage is a little bit lower. And the current output is 5.86 amps. That's because it took that higher voltage and it dropped it down. So you've got your lower voltage coming out, but your higher current coming out. So that is 5.85 amps. So now let's change it around and connect the 12 volt 50 watt panel. Okay, so now we've got our 12 volt 50 watt panel connected, and I'm seeing 18 volts in. That makes perfect sense. It's got an 18 volt VMP, and the output is 3.08 amps. Now it's got a 2.78 amp IMP, short circuit current at maximum power. So that means the MPPT charge controller is actually boosting that current up a little bit. So we're getting better than standard test conditions from this solar panel going through the MPPT charge controller. That's kind of nice. So let's call it 3.08 amps on its own. All right, and remember we were up almost at 6 amps with the 100 watt panel. Makes sense, it's twice the watts. It was putting out twice the current. So let's wire the two of them together in parallel and see what kind of combined numbers we get coming out of it. All right?
Yes. There we go.
All right, so we've got these two panels wired in parallel, the 24 volt 100 watt and the 12 volt 50 watt wired in parallel. Now you see the voltage going into the charge controller has actually been pulled way down. Remember when we just had the 24 volt solar panel, we were up around 36 volts, 34 volts, somewhere around there. And what we're seeing now is 20 volts. So what's happening is this 12 volt solar panel being wired in parallel is pulling that voltage way down. And because this is on the input of the charge controller, unlike on the output of the charge controller where it drops the volts but raises the amps, it's not increasing the amps. So we're just losing a tremendous amount of power because watts equals volts times amps. If we're dropping the volts down but leaving the amps the same, we're losing a lot of power. So let's look at the output of this. We're getting 6.29 amps coming out at 12.7 volts. That's pretty lousy considering what we were getting with just a single panel in there. So let's wire the two of them in series now, go into that MPPT charge controller. Because they both have the same amps but different volts, we're going to keep the amps the same going through the whole string. We're going to add the volts together, and then the charge controller will drop those volts down while increasing the amps. So let's see what we get with that, all right? The negative from the 12 volt panel is going to the charge controller, the positive is going to the negative of the 24 volt panel, and then the positive of that panel is going into the charge controller. So you can see we've got 52 volts going into the charge controller. That's the addition of the two panels wired together. And if we look at the current output, we're at 8.38 amps out at 13 volts. So that's definitely the best power output that we've gotten. So wiring the two solar panels, same amps, different volts, in series into an MPPT charge controller is the best solution if you can't give each of them their own charge controller. I hope this was helpful. If so, give us a like and a share, and be sure to subscribe to our Alti Store channel so we'll notify you when new videos are coming out. And don't forget to check us out at www.altistore.com, where we've been making renewable doable since 1999.